Magandang araw mga classmate. Muli ay narito tayo upang pag-aralan ng aralin na may kinalaman sa Mathematics 10. Quarter 1, Most Essential Learning Competency Number 1. O ang ikalawang bahagi ng ating lesson about Generating Patterns. Para sa ating objective, write the rule for the nth term of a sequence. Sa ating nakalipas na aralin ay ating nalaman kung ano ang kahulugan ng sequence and other terms related sa sequence. So nalaman din natin that sometimes a sequence or a pattern in a sequence can be written or the sequence itself can be written in what we call the general term o yung tinatawag natin na nth term. Okay. So, meron akong halimbawa ng n term. So, we have here a sub n equals to 5n plus 2. So, ang n term, so ito yung nagbibigay sa atin ng idea. So, ano-ano yung mga element ng sequence. Okay, so let's say we want to know the first term. So, we'll just simply substitute 1 or replace n by 1. So, we'll have 5 times 1 plus 2. So, when we simplify this, so we have 5 times 1 is 5 plus 2. So, this is 7. So, ibig sabihin, ang unang term or ang first term ng ating sequence is 7. So, we'll do the same thing para malaman natin kung ano yung second term. So, we'll have 5 times 2 is 10 plus 2. So, we have here 12. So, ang second term ng ating sequence ay 12. So, we're going to do the same thing para makuha natin yung a sub 3 and so on. Okay, so before we proceed with our lesson, so subukan muna nating sagutin itong ating exercise na meron tayo. So we'll just simply fill up the correct answer sa mga missing term ng ating equation. So number 1, we have 3 times 2 plus 12. So 3 times 2 is 6 plus 12. So we have here 18 sa number 1. Number 2, we have... So, blank multiplied by 5 plus 6, the answer is positive 1. So, ano yung number na kapag minultiply natin sa 5, we'll, at inadd natin sa positive 6, ay magbibigay sa atin ng positive 1. Okay, so the answer here is negative 1. Because negative 1 times 5, so we have here negative 5 plus 6, the answer is positive 1. Okay, so let's proceed with our third item. So, 1 half times blank minus 9 is equal to negative 8. Okay. So, ano naman yung number na kapag multiply natin sa 1 half at binawasan natin ng 9 ay magiging negative 8 ang sagot. So, dapat yung ating first term ay magiging positive 1. Okay, so we can multiply 1 half by 2. So 1 half times 2, so matitira dyan is 1. So 1 minus 9, the answer is negative 8. Okay, so proceed tayo sa pang-apat na item. So we have here blank times 3 plus 5 equals 7. So ano naman yung number na kapag minultiply natin sa positive 3, at nagdagdag tayo ng 5 will give us 7. Okay. So alam natin na dapat magdagdag tayo ng 2 sa 5 para maging 7. So ibig sabihin, ang sagot natin dito sa fourth item ay fraction. So ang sagot natin dito is 2/3. Because 2/3 times 3, so this will be cancelled. So ang matitira dito is 2. So, 2 plus 5, the answer is 7. What if this time, we want to know kung ano yung nth term ng isang sequence? So, disclaimer lang. So, there are several ways or techniques for us to determine the nth term of a given sequence But in this particular lesson ay gagamitin natin ay more on observation. So that's why it is very important for us to determine kung ano yung pattern na meron yung sequence. Okay, so subukan nating sagutin yung unang example na meron tayo. So we have 5, 12, 19, 26, 33, and so on. Okay, so for us to proceed dun sa ating sagot, so alamin muna natin ano yung pattern. So based from the sequence, so pwede nating sabihin na ang pattern ay nag-a-add tayo ng positive 7. Okay, so 5 plus 7 is 12, 12 plus 7, 19, 19 plus 7 is 26, 26 plus 7 is 33. Okay, then we can now proceed dun sa ating part ng sagot. Okay, so using this number, itong 7, so we'll just simply write a sub n equals to 7n. Okay, so muli, itong ginagawa natin ay bahagi pa lang ng sagot. So bakit bahagi pa lang? So we can do yung second step kung saan substitute natin a sub 1 equals to, so sabi natin ang part ng solution is 7n. So palitan natin yung n ng 1. So we have 7 times 1. So the answer here is 7. Question, so ano yung dapat nating idagdag sa 7 para makuha natin yung 5 dahil siya yung first term ng ating sequence? So we can add negative 2. So ibig sabihin, pwede tayong mag-subtract ng 2. So 7 times 1, so we have here 7 minus 2, the answer is 5. Okay, second term natin. Again, so 7 times 2, we have here 14, pero ang ating second term is 12. So anong gagawin? We are going to subtract 2 sa 14 para makuha natin ang second term. Third term, so we have here 7 times 3. The answer here is 21. Again, so ang third term natin is 19. So babawasan uli natin ng 2 para makuha natin yung third term. Okay, so we can continue this or we can stop from here and then let us analyze yung ating naging solutions. Okay, so kung mapapansin nyo, meron tayo ditong pare-parehas na ginawa kung saan nagbawas tayo ng 2. So this will be part also of the n term. So ang ating magiging final answer ay 7n minus 2. So eto ngayon yung ating n term. Okay. So proceed tayo sa second example. We have 15, 12, 9, 6, 3, and so on. So just like what we did dun sa unang example, so analyze muna natin yung sequence. So kung mapapansin nyo, so dito ay nag-a-add tayo ng negative 3. So 15 plus negative 3 is 12, 12 plus negative 3. So that will also give us 9. 9 plus negative 3 or 9 minus 3. Ang magiging sagot is positive 6. 6 minus 3 is 3. So bakit ginawa ko na lang negative or minus 3? Kasi positive or plus times negative, still ang sagot natin dito negative. Okay. So, magiging part ng solution natin, we have a sub n, since ang hinahanap natin ay n term. So, we'll have negative 3, at gagamitin natin tong numbers na to. Negative 3n. Again, so this is applicable for this type of sequence. Kasi sa susunod na example, so another approach naman ang gagawin natin. So, we have negative 3n. Check natin a sub 1. So we'll have negative 3 replace n by 1. So we'll have negative 3 times 1. The answer here is negative 3. Pero ang ating first term ay 15. So ano dapat ang idadagdag natin or ibabawas para makuha natin yung first term na positive 15? So if we have here negative 3, so dapat magdagdag tayo ng 18 para makuha natin positive 15. Okay, so check natin to kung applicable siya sa second term. So we have a sub 2, we have here negative 3 times n natin is 2. So the answer here is negative 6. So negative 6, try natin kung mag-i-add tayo ng 18. So ang sagot dito is 12, which is true dun sa ating second term. Subukan uli natin sa third term. We have negative 3 times 3. So add tayo ng 18. So negative 3 times 3, we have here negative 9 plus 18. So that will give us positive 9, which is true dun sa ating given sequence. So again, based dun sa ating naging solution, nag-a-add tayo ng 18 dun sa ating partial answer na nth term. So ilalagay natin ito dito sa ating partial answer. And ang ating magiging nth term para sa second example is a sub n equals to negative 3n plus 18. Okay, so for our third example, so we have 3, 9, 27, 81, and so on. Okay, so again, observe muna natin yung sequence. So kung mapapansin natin yung sequence, so pwede nating sabihin na yung next term ay nakukuha by multiplying positive 3 to its preceding term. Pwede rin nating sabihin that each term is the result of squaring or getting the or using 3 as the base. And then yung exponent niya will start from 1. 3 raised to 1 is 3. So here we have here 3 raised to 2. So that is 3 times 3. So that is 9. Third term natin is the result of 3 times 3. So that is 9 times 3 or 3 raised to 3. So same with 81, which is equal to 3 raised to 4. Okay, so we can now write the nth term. So again, using itong pare-parehas na number, so we'll use that as 3. And then if you will notice, so magkakaiba yung ating naging exponent, so we can replace that by n. Okay, tingnan natin kung ito na yung ating final answer. Check natin. A sub 1, so 3, again, replace natin yung n, so we'll have 3 raised to 1, so that is equal to 3. Okay, so tama siya dun sa ating first term. Second term natin, we have 3 raised to 2. So this is 9, which is also true dun sa ating second term. Third term natin, we have 3 raised to 3. So this is equal to 27, which is true dun sa ating given sequence. So therefore, wala na tayong idadagdag dun sa ating ginawang end term kanina. So ito na yung ating magiging end term ng given na sequence. So we have a sub n equals to 3 raised to n. Okay, so for our last example, we have here 1/4, 1 over 9, 1 over 16, and 1 over 25, and so on. Okay, so analyze uli natin yung ating given sequence. So from here, pwede tayong mag-umpisa by rewriting the given sequence. Bakit kailangan i-rewrite? Kasi yung 1 can also be written as 1 over 1. So para mas malinaw nating makita kung ano yung pattern ng ating sequence. Okay, So since ang ating numerator ay pare-parehas na 1, so we can start with a sub n equals to 1 all over. Ito na lang yung ating titingnan ng pattern. So we have 1, 4, 9, 16, 25. So yung 1, 4, 9, 16, and 25, so yan ay result ng integers kapag in-square mo siya. Kapag nag-umpisa tayo sa positive 1. Okay, check natin. So 1 raised to 2, the answer is 1. 2 raised to 2, the answer is 4. 3 raised to 2, the answer here is 9. 4 raised to 2, so that is equal to 16. 5 raised to 2 is equal to 25. So therefore, ang ating magiging n term is 1 all over. So dahil ang pare-parehas dito ay yung exponent, so ibig sabihin, ang exponent natin ay 2 at ang base natin yung naiiba. So ibig sabihin, yun yung n natin. So ang ating magiging n term is a sub n equals to 1 all over n square. Okay, so pwede nating i-check a sub 1 using this n term. So we have 1 all over, ang n natin is 1, 1 raised to 2. So the answer is 1 over 1 or 1. Second term natin, we have 1 all over 2 raised to 2. So 2 raised to 2, again, sabi natin is 4. So our final answer is 1/4. Okay, yun. True siya doon sa ating given na second term ng sequence. I-sub 3 natin. We have 1 all over 3 raised to 2. So this is equal to 1 over 9. Third term natin is 1 over 9. Okay, parehas doon sa given na sequence. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so this time it's your turn. Write an expression for the n term of the given sequence. Assume that n starts at 1.